Okay, ma'am, what is the tubal evaluation test that you mentioned here?
Yes, as I've told you, from an ultrasound, usually we will not be able to get a clear picture of the tubes. Usually what we can see in an ultrasound would be the uterus and the ovaries. Mm-hmm. So the tubal evaluation would include usually an X-ray test called as the HSG. This is to assess the tubal patency. That is whether the tube is hollow or not. Once it is hollow only, it will be able to carry out its function. So other tests would be a laparoscopy. If we fail to see a result with the hysterosalpingography, that is a HSG, we might ask for a laparoscopy to be done. In laparoscopy, what we are looking for is also a tubal spillage to see whether the tubes are patent or not, or whether it's hollow and working. So usually this these two tests are which gives us a clear idea. HSG, as it doesn't give a very good idea, because it's usually we just need can know it's spillage or not, but spasm and all might be missed in a tubal HSG testing. So laparoscopy is actually what we say the gold standard or the best test, because we can know whether there is tubal spasm, the tube is patent or not, or there are any surrounding the tube, any problems are there or not. We can get a clear picture with laparoscopy. So I would say laparoscopy as the best test for tubal assessment.
كما تقول هي لابروسكوبي هي الفحص في الأنبوب, يعني في أنبوب المرأة وأيضا أنبوب الذكر, يعني أن هذه الحيوانات المنية والبيض يخرجون من جهة الناس, يعني من جهة الرجل وجهة المرأة, لا يمكنهم أن يكتشفوا هل هي تعمل بشكل طيب أو طبيعي أم لا. باستخدام هذه الفحص المعاصر يمكنهم أن يعرف أنها تعمل بطريقة سوي أم لا. إذن هذه هي أجد, وفي هذه الطريقة يمكننا أن نعرف ونعالج هذا المرض, يعني العقم هذه من جهة النساء والذكر معا. Ma'am, I heard يعني a lot of about heavy menstrual bleeding. What are the reasons for that?
Okay, heavy menstrual bleeding is a very common complaint which we see in the OPD. I think once the patient is over 40, this complaint comes more often than in a younger age. Or it can even happen in very young age girls, less than 20, teen girls. Mm. Also, this heavy menstrual bleeding is a very common complaint. But there are lots of causes. But if you can generalize, I would say to be some cause, most of the causes could be a hormonal cause, or else it could be a problem within the uterus or a structural problem, or not just the uterus, ovaries, cervix, anything, a structural problem, or it could be a hormonal problem. So when we assess a patient with heavy menstrual bleeding, definitely we can get some hints from the history of the patient. Then we go for the evaluation. That would include a hormonal evaluation. Mm-hmm. Definitely we have to rule out pregnancy in any cases of heavy menstrual bleeding. Then after that, we'll go for a scan to see whether any structural problems are there. But most of the things like a fibroid, a uterine wall thickening like an adenomyosis, all these can be picked up in a scan. Sometimes even pelvic inflammation and pelvic infections, that can also cause heavy menstrual bleeding. Sometimes the causes could be to the womb opening, that is called the cervix, can also present as a case of heavy menstrual bleeding. But when we look at young girls, the problem won't be structural mostly, the problem will be a hormone disturbance. So we'll have a hormone assessment. Sometimes it could be even a problem with the blood coagulation, so that can also present as a case of heavy menstrual bleeding.
والآن سألتها عن نزيف الرحم. نزيف الرحم كما نعرف إنها سيل كمية كبيرة من الدم من جسم الفتيات والنساء. إن سبب هذه المرض إن النساء يعانون من مشاكل كثيرة في التركيب, يعني تورم في الرحم أو عدم وجود الكرة الدموية الحمراء, ولكن أن البنات الصغار إنهم يعانون من نفس هذه المشكلة, لذا يفقدون القوة والذاكرة بفقدان الدم من جسدهم, وهذا السبب أسباب هرمونية لأنهم غيروا أطعمتهم وسلوكهم في العادات الذين يعيشون فيها. إذا هذه هي المشكلة في نزيف الرحم في البنات الصغار الذين بلغ عمرهم 20 أو أقل. لكن نزيف الرحم عادة يعاني منها المرأة الكبيرة بعد الولادة مرة أو مرتين. Okay, ma'am, one last question. I know that recurrent pregnancy loss is the most complicated problem that pregnant woman suffers from. What is the reason for that and what is the treatment for that?
Okay, very nice question, Hiba. Recurrent pregnancy loss, we can term it as recurrent only if a lady loses at least three pregnancy losses consecutively. We are like most of the people might experience one or two losses, but that will not term it as recurrent pregnancy loss. At least three pregnancy losses, we can say it as a cause of that being a term of recurrent pregnancy loss. So as there are many causes, it could be many causes. Most common cause being a chromosomal problem of the baby. It could be either from the parents. Sometimes not even parents need to have it, the baby can have it. So that is the most common problem. But if the baby is normal and if the patient is experiencing lots of pregnancy losses somewhere towards the middle of the pregnancy, it might be usually be a cervical or uterine problems. So that that can be quite common. Then other causes can be some hormonal problems or diabetic, patient being mother being diabetic or father being diabetic can also contribute. Sometimes thyroid problems and sometimes problems like, you know, lupus or rheumatoid problems, all these can cause. That is autoimmune problems in the mother can also reject the baby. So that these are some of the common causes of pregnancy losses.
والحين سألتها عن فقدان العلق المستمر من رحم الأم. إنها قالت إن هذا المرض يسمى إذا ضاعت الأم أو إذا فقدت الأم العلق ثلاث مرات على الأقل من رحمها. إنها السبب لمن يعاني من مرض السكر إما الوالد أو الوالدة. لا يمكن للعلق أن يلتصق في جدران الرحم وبعض الأحيان إن هذا الطفل يعاني من مشكلة إن لم يعانيها الوالدين لذا لا يمكنها أن تلصق في جدار الرحم هذه هي المشكلة لفقدان العلق من جدران الرحم في هذه الآونة أحبائي الكرام إنكم سمعتم الأسئلة والأجوبة التي سألتها والتي جاوبتني في هذا المجال يعني مجال العقم إذا أنكم تعانون من هذه الأمراض لديكم وإنكم لا تجدون العلاج الصحيح لذلك عليكم أن تزوروا مستشفى عندنا في كيرلا في كوتشي إنها اسمها لايفلاين إن هذه الطبيبة تعمل هناك منذ أعوام هي عالجت كثيرا من المرضى الذين يعانوا من هذه المشكلة يعني مشكلة العقم لا تحسبوا إن لديكم إن لا لديكم هذا العلاج لكننا نتوفر لكم هذا العلاج بطريقتها الصحيحة وأشكرها شكرا جزيلا لفرصتنا فرصتها له يعني لإعطائنا فرصتها أي وقتها الغالية للأجوبة الصحيحة في هذا المجال إذن it was a great time with you and thank you for your valuable information about this field and thank you so much.
Thank you Hiba, it was a pleasure talking to you as well. Thank you.